When you're thirsty for a soft drink, you may not give a lot of thought to the logo design, bottle shape, or flavor options. But there's a lot of research that goes on behind the scenes before a product shows up on store shelves. An exhibit called Prototypes and Beyond at the Dr. Pepper Museum educates visitors about the process with samples and some hits and misses. In the display titled Countdown to Cool, museum visitors get a look at the thought process that went into developing the new logo released by Dr. Pepper in 2005. The Dr. Pepper Museum actually helped with the company's research by providing examples of logos used throughout the product's history.
The Dr. Pepper brand team looks at historic Dr. Pepper logos for a variety of reasons. They're looking to see where the product has been and what design trends have been there in the product. As you notice with a lot of Dr. Pepper logos, you'll see that many of them have been the shape of an oval. A lot of them have been red or maroon colored, and so those things are really identified with the Dr. Pepper logo. And so in developing the current logo, they wanted to grow on those ideas. That way they could connect to previous consumers who have been Dr. Pepper fans for years, but also change it enough that it keeps up with current cultural trends and bring in new consumers.
Part of the logo design process involves brainstorming adjectives that consumers identify with a product, such as original, daily, or nostalgia. The display includes designs that were rejected for being either too close to the original design or too extreme.
Consumers play a vital role in the logo development process. After several new logos have been created, they're presented to consumer focus groups who are able to narrow down the choices available. The Dr. Pepper brand team may then go back and tweak some of them and present it to the consumers again. But by the time it gets to store shelves, even though most consumers may not have realized that a new logo was being developed and the first time they see it is on a store shelf, their opinions have really been taken into consideration with the consumer focus groups beforehand.
An interactive display builds on the idea of consumers identifying with Dr. Pepper by asking visitors to choose from a list of adjectives, which one they most identify with Dr. Pepper, and then to pick a favorite logo from the most recent Dr. Pepper logos and some that were rejected in the latest round of logo development. The logo design process is again underway for Dr. Pepper as their 125th anniversary approaches in 2010. Museum visitors have the opportunity to view some of the designs being considered for the soft drinks anniversary, such as the always unique design which features popular Dr. Pepper slogans, our anniversary splash with images such as a cowboy hat, the wheat and iron image from 1891, and even the Dr. Pepper Museum. The exhibit also includes some interactive elements for visitors. They can design their own Dr. Pepper logo and vote for their favorite logo on display at the museum by taking a photo by the display. The visitors can then email their logo design or photos to the museum staff. The next display is titled Countdown to Bottle Design. Visitors learn about the issues that soft drink corporations consider when developing a new bottle.
Three things that they really do take into consideration are how strong and durable the bottle design will be, so it won't crack or break. Need to make sure that the design, once it gets onto the manufacturing line, is going to go through the line okay. There's those operational characteristics. And then the other thing that they take into consideration is actually how it's going to look once it gets onto store shelves. They want it to be easily distinguished from other products that are sitting next to it on the shelf so that when you walk up to it, you know that that's the product that you want.
The display includes a football-shaped bottle of Dr. Pepper used as part of a special promotion, as well as three bottles without labels, with a challenge to identify the product based on the distinct shapes. There are also some unusual aluminum cans with plastic tops that are prototypes from the 1970s that never reached store shelves. One of the hottest trends in the soft drink industry is taking a familiar brand and offering variations with fruit combinations or herbal pairings. A soft drink releases a new flavor only after extensive consumer research.
For the development of a new flavor extension for a soft drink company, they do several things. They begin by brainstorming. How many people begin their thought process for a new product anyways? They come up with a list of flavors while they're brainstorming and present those ideas to consumers. Consumers then narrow that list down for them by telling them which ones they would actually buy or not. And they then take that list to their soft drink engineers who begin mixing the flavors. Those mixed flavors then go back to the consumers who get to taste test them and decide maybe it needs a little bit more of this or that. So the soft drink engineers tweak the formula. They do another run with a small consumer group and then put it out to do a larger run across the country. Once it's finally gotten approval and passed all of those inspections, it's ready to be marketed and put on store shelves.
Some unsuccessful examples were Dr. Pepper's Red Fusion and 7-Up's DNL, which is supposed to look like 7-Up upside down. Both were released in the early 2000s.
When you take a look at the packaging for Red Fusion and DNL, you really have to look at it long and closely before you realize that they're a Dr. Pepper product in the case of Red Fusion, or with DNL, it's a 7-Up product. And so those particular flavor extensions didn't capitalize on the brand identity that was already out there for the products of Dr. Pepper and 7-Up. And because of that, it just didn't connect with consumers and therefore didn't last as long.
In recent years, Dr. Pepper has released Cherry Vanilla Dr. Pepper and a Cherry Chocolate version. 7-Up has released a mixed berry flavor, and Snapple has a white tea product with green apple. The next interactive exhibit allows museum visitors to select their favorite flavor of Dr. Pepper. The last display, Countdown to Diets, provides a historical account of the first diet soft drink released by 7-Up in the early 1960s. The company first seriously considered the name DAT, short for Diet Answer to Thirst. 7-Up developed logos with a DAT name along with bottle designs, but eventually settled on the name Like, which was released in 1963. The soft drink later was reformulated and renamed Diet 7-Up. A visit to the Dr. Pepper Museum provides a behind-the-scenes look at the marketing decisions that go into developing the brand identity that's made Dr. Pepper one of the most successful soft drinks for the past 124 years.